Hi friends, welcome to PremSoft technical channel. In the C language project series, today we are going to see the project number 5 and part number 2. In the part 1, we have seen how to find the GST on the single product. In today's lecture, I am going to explain you about how to find the GST on the multiple product. For that, first we will read from the user how many products he is going to sell. Now suppose I am going to sell the 3 products, okay? Now all the 3 products will be different type. So first product quantity, first product amount, first product GST. This first product amount is nothing but price of the product, and then GST on that particular product and total product. Suppose example, I am having the quantity, I have purchased the 10, and my price is suppose each one 15 rupees, and on this GST I am applying suppose 5%. Then total will be like 10 product I am purchasing 15 rupees amount, so 150 rupees and 5% GST on that one. Nothing but how much? It is 5% GST is 7.5. So total will be 157. Here it will print 157.5. Okay, now this is about one product. Like this, how many product we are having? 3. So it will read the 3 product quantity, 3 product amount, 3 product GST and total, and then finally it will print the grand total. So how to do this application in C language, today we are going to see. So let's start with the program, guys. First we'll take the variables, guys. In the last lecture I forgot to inform you, if you want the values in the decimal, you can take instead of integer, you can use the float to find out the average. But just to make the application simple, I am taking the values, all the values in integer. So first I want what? First we will find total product. So I will directly read the product. So here it we will read how many product he is having. Next, product, I will use the shortcut for this was, guys. See, I will give here product quantity PQ, product amount PA, PG and PT. We will take this 4 variable, okay? We have to remember PQ, PA, here PQ, comma PA, comma PG, comma PT, nothing but total, okay? Now, first we have to read, enter the total product type, means how many type of product is going to sell. Scanf, I will read here percentile D, comma address of product, because we are going to read what? Product. If you want to give shortcut, guys, I will take it P, because we will use multiple time, so we'll take short variable name. So here we have read number of product. We'll put this into one for loop. I will take I is equals to 0, I less than how many product we are having, that many times it will repeat, and I plus plus. Because guys, we are taking for loop because multiple product amount we are going to find out. And make sure, guys, one thing you have to remember, array starts from 0, so that's why I have taken 0. So first we'll read what? Printf, first product. So I will type here percentile D, product quantity, means how much quantity is there of first product. Scanf, we'll store into which variable, guys, and we'll create all the variable into array, because we'll take max will be 10. You can just change size as per your requirement, means maximum 10 product I'm considering here. You can change this value as per your requirement, guys. And here I will take percentile D, comma address of product quantity. Product quantity we are storing into PQ. PQ of I. Why I? Because one product, two product, it will goes on. I value will be 0. So 0 product, 1 product, like this. And from here we have to pass the value, guys. Here we are passing I, but I value is what? 0. But front we want to show first product, second product, like this. So we will take I plus 1. So it will print 1, 2, 3, guys. Similarly, we have to do it for what? I will just copy this and I will paste this for product amount, product GST amount, okay? So we'll just take it here, product quantity. Here I will change to product GST. Sorry, second is what? Product amount. So I will take it product amount. Order is not important, guys. You can change the order as per your requirement. PA and then product GST percent. Okay, so this is about the GST percent. So here we'll change PG. Okay, so like we are reading for what? First products, like suppose if I enter 3, so it will take first product quantity, first product amount, first product GST, then I plus plus, second product amount, second product quantity, second product GST. Like this, how many you have given, that many products it will take it. And then here we have to find the, we will take the total also, comma, total of 10 I will take it. And here only I will calculate the total. How to calculate the total? I will take total of I is equals to, what is the formula, guys? First we have to find the GST. To find out the GST, we will take PQ. First we have to find the quantity. Quantity into PA. So quantity is nothing but PQ of I, means first product quantity into first product amount. So I am giving here I. Suppose, guys, I will give one example. My first product quantity is 10 and my first product PA, nothing but amount, is 15. So 10 into 15, it is 150 rupees. So I have to give here multiplication symbol. So this is up to here. We will get the product quantity. Plus I have to apply the GST percent on this whole thing. Now suppose on the 150 rupees, I have to apply the 5% GST, correct? So I will take that amount here. I will take again this, I will do this same calculation. Okay, nothing but this amount into, otherwise I will do one thing, guys. I will just simplify this one so you will understand in a better way. I will remove this from here. I will take one short variable here that is called T. T is equals to temporary variable, I called it. I am finding here total and comma, T is equals to initially I will give 0, just temporary variable. Here PQ of I into PA of I, nothing but total it will find out. Here I will write T plus in bracket T into product GST by 100. Now how to calculate this, guys? Suppose T is nothing but this is, we will see with this example. Product quantity is 10 and product amount is 15. So 10 into 15 is 150 rupees. 150 into 5. 150 into 5 how much, guys? It is 750 divided by 100. 750 divided by 100. Nothing but what? 7.5. So this is what GST on this amount. And then total is 150. Then 150 plus 7.5 is 157.5. Like this it will come, guys. If you want, guys, I will give the number so that only integer will come. If you want the values in the float, you can take all the values in float instead of int. That is also possible. Now otherwise you can take total in the decimal. So this whole I will put into one more bracket. Okay, I will write here. So this, you have solved the first thing. Again, after this completion of this, we have to make T is equals to 0 for next calculation. So this is about what first product we have found. Now we want to print all the products at a time. So I will take for I will print all the products. I is equals to 0. Here, guys, in this for loop only we are reading the values. Now I want to print. So how to print? I less than P, nothing but product I plus plus. Now while printing, we have to do like this. First, what we want to print? Printf. I want to print product quantity. I will use shortcut, guys. See, first product quantity, product Q. Here little bit spelling. Product quantity. Here PQ space product amount space product GST space total. Okay, similarly we'll print here, printf will use, here will be used guys like this. Okay, first what we want to print, percentile D space percentile D percentile D, we are using all percentile D. Now comma, I will give here first PQ is nothing but product quantity PQ of I. This is very important guys. Next PA of I, nothing but product amount, comma PG of I, nothing but GST percentage of first product, and then total, total of I. Okay, this is very simple guys. Now first we'll save this program. So go to file, save as. I will give this program, already we have seen last program 5, this I will change like program 5.1, nothing but second part, dot C is mandatory. Now go to execute, compile, it is compiling. Okay, we did not declare the I, so I will just add here I. Now go to execute, once again compile the program. Temporary variable we have declared, so t is equals to, we'll check the what is the error, go to view, floating point report, we can check the error like this guys. It will show us what is the error, invalid operand to binary. Okay, t into pg of I will come guys. Okay, because we have taken array, so that's why the error was coming. Here semicolon is missing. Okay, now it's everything is fine, execution is done. Now run the program. Now enter the total product guys. Suppose I am entering the three products. First product quantity I am taking 10, first product amount I am taking suppose 20 rupees is my first product amount, and first product GST I am taking 10%. Now product second I am taking suppose 50 products, each product amount is 5 rupees, and each GST on the second product is 12%. Guys, I am changing the percent, you can take any percent, this is up to you. Third 20 products, product amount I am taking 16 rupees, and the GST I am taking here 18%. Okay, now check it guys, it is coming all the thing in single line. I think I have written here, okay, slash n we have to add guys, sorry for this, we have to add slash n, and here also we have to add slash n, so it will come on the new line. So once again we'll compile the program after changing and run the program. Now once again I will give only two products, first product 10, amount is first product amount 15 rupees, and GST I will apply 10%. Second product quantities I am giving 20 is quantity, product amount 5 rupees, and GST will be 18%. Now see guys, first product amount is 10 rupees, first product quantity is 10, amount is 15, percentage in GST is 10, total is 165. 10 into 15 150, and GST on 10% 150 on 150 10% GST is 15 rupees, so 150 plus 15 165. Now here again 20 products amount is 5 rupees, 20 into 5 100 rupees, on 100 we are having 18% GST, nothing but 18 rupees, so total amount will be 118. So like this we can found. Now if you want to find here grand total, nothing but 165 and 118, and we want to print here, that is also possible. How to do that I will tell you. Now see, to print the grand total what we have to do, we have to take one more variable, that is called the grand total. So I will just take it here, I will take total of, I will take one variable called the grand total, that is GT is equals to total of I plus GT, nothing but grand total, it will find the grand total. I will take one more variable at the last, that is comma GT is equals to 0. And I will just print this statement after this one. printf. Okay, and here I will print grand total is equals to percentile D, and here I will print GT. Okay, so once again I will compile, guys. How to print the grand total, I will tell you. Compile. I have taken one variable and only I am adding total of I, guys, nothing but first total into GT, again second total into GT. Compile the program, once again run the program. Okay, once again I am taking two product, first 10 product amount is 20 rupees and GST percent 5, second product quantity 30, amount is 10 and GST percent is 10. Okay, so now see, 10 product 20 rupees price and 5 rupees GST is 210, 30 quantity 10 rupees price, GST is 10, nothing but 330, 210 plus 330, nothing but grand total is 540 rupees. So like this also we can display. If we can just take little bit spaces less, it will come in proper alignment. I hope, guys, you have liked this video. Still, if you are feeling any doubts or any difficulty, please mail me on this mail ID, or you can call me on this number. Please like and subscribe my channel if you like this video. Thank you for watching this video, guys.